Hi, it's Kiffin Lobates here, and today I want to talk a bit about software engineering and particular about edge cases, because I have about, must be 15, about 15 years experience in the past as a test engineer. And one of the things that has always struck me is that developers are very good at coding up the core functionality of a computer program, but the area where they fall down time and time again is in edge cases. So, what exactly is an edge case? Well, it's a case that deviates from the norm to such an extent that the code that has been provided to deal with the ordinary everyday occurrences of the system no longer functions. And a classic example of this would be, for example, the signing up page of a website where all you have to do is enter your first name, your last name, and your email address in order to sign up. Now, how tricky can that be? And the answer is surprisingly tricky. For example, my surname is a double-barreled name, so there's a hyphen in there, and I've lost track of the number of times that I've been unable to enter my name correctly into a sign-up page because they reject the hyphen as an invalid character. And I know people have had this problem when they have Irish names like O'Leary, and forget about having a Nordic name, say, with umlaut letters or O's with lines through them or stuff like that. These kind of things all cause problems. Another problem that sometimes arises is that the developer assumes because they have a middle name that everybody must have a middle name. And that is patently not the case. I don't have a middle name. My proper name is Keir Findlay Bates. No Michael or John or Christopher hiding in the middle there. So I've had cases where websites have rejected me, and I've had to invent a middle name precisely because of that. Then you can kind of see there that you think, okay, well, we'll cover that case. More and more keep crawling out of the woodwork. So there's a good video where a developer called Tom talks about problems with time. There's another case where you think, how hard can it be to work out how many seconds have passed between two different dates and times? And in that video, Tom just goes through, I think it's 10 minutes, where he shows that this apparently simple problem gets more and more complicated until, as a developer, you eventually just want to tear your hair out and throw yourself off a cliff. So when you are putting together a system, especially if it impacts people's lives, so for example a government system, you have to be very, very careful, because if you're expecting to deal with millions of people signing up, you only need 0.1% of your users of the system to deviate so much from the average that they can't use the system properly. And then if you're looking at 1 million citizens signing up, right, then suddenly you're looking at, you know, 1,000 people who are going to be unable to use your system, and that's a significant number of people. So anyway, that's just something to draw developers' attention to. Think about the edge cases. Don't just think that everybody is like you, because they're not. Most people are not like you at all. Okay, that's today's video on an issue in software engineering. Hope you found it interesting, and see you in the next video soon. Bye for now.